Haas uses weight covers to protect ball screws, linear guides, and other components from chips, coolant, and any other debris that presents in the machine cutting zone. However, if the wipers on the weight covers become damaged, the components beneath the weight covers are at risk of being damaged. In this video, we're going to show you how to replace the wipers on your Y-axis weight covers. If your machine experiences heavy usage, we recommend you replace the wipers on the weight covers on an annual basis, just as you would with the windshield wipers on your car. As I've mentioned before in a previous video, during normal machine operation, the coolant lubricates the weight covers, so it's very important that you mix the coolant concentration correctly. But not all application requires coolant. So in those cases where coolant isn't used, be sure to use a lightweight oil to lubricate the weight cover wipers. If you continually run the machine without weight cover lubrication, the wipers will break down prematurely. We're going to review how to replace the wipers on the weight covers installed on machine built from June 2019 to current. We will put a link in the description below of how to replace the wipers on earlier version weight covers. Let's get into it. Jog the axis to the end of travel to extend the weight cover. E-stop the machine. Remove the weight cover. Flip it over and remove each section. Remove each section by expanding the smallest leaf. Hold the small leaf in one hand and the next leaf in the other hand. Apply some outward pressure, rock it back and forth, and separate the leaves. Follow the same process to separate all the leaves. With the leaves all separated, pull the old wiper off the edge of the weight cover. Wipe away the excess grease and carefully inspect the brass seals on the sides, the plastic slides, and the bumper, and use a dead blow mallet to remove any dents from the weight covers. These bumpers are new. They were added to the weight cover assembly in September of 2021. However, they are not backwards compatible. The bumpers were designed into the weight cover as a cushion and to eliminate as much noise as possible. Therefore, as you inspect the weight covers and notice a couple of the bumpers are damaged or missing, the weight covers will still function properly. So here I have the four wipers for the four leaves that I'll be installing. So you select the wipers as you go along for the leaf that you will install. So the largest wiper goes for the largest leaf, the next larger one, next one, and then the last one. So as you lay out the wipers, you'll realize that there's no cutting necessary to install these wipers. As you are preparing to insert each wiper, take a moment to make sure the length of each clear tubing is fully inserted in its proper channel of the wiper. This hose acts as a bumper and spacer for each wiper. There will be a gap of approximately an eighth of an inch on either side of the wiper once installed. This is done by design. It prevents the wipers from interfering with the sidewalls and create a wrinkle. Once you locate the correct wiper for the leaf that you're working on, insert the slotted section of the wiper over the edge of the weight cover and press it firmly in place. Then apply a light coat of grease to the wiper. Install each leaf one at a time by placing one edge of the leaf inside the front edge of the larger leaf. Apply downward pressure to insert the other side. As you're applying downward pressure, remember that you're compressing that clear tubing we just looked at. Evenly applied force over the entire cover will help compress the tube and slide the leaf into place. Follow this process to install all the leaves. With the new wipers installed on the way covers, and with this area of the machine still open, clean any chips or coolant that may have gotten through the way cover wipers. Remove the old gasket from the casting or way covers if it's damaged. Apply a thin coat of grease to the guide bars and install the way covers over the guide bars. If necessary, install a new gasket on the casting. Apply a small bead of RTV silicone on the face of the way cover. Install the fasteners to the front. Extend the way cover, install the fasteners to the side, then secure it to the casting, and then wipe away any excess silicone from around the way cover. Release the e-stop and press reset a couple times to clear the alarm. Apply a light coat of oil to each section of the way cover. Jog the axis slowly and make sure the way cover does not bind. Follow the same process to replace the X-axis way cover wipers. Remember, we recommend replacing the wipers on your machine after a year of heavy usage or anytime it appears that the wipers are not providing proper seal against the cover. For more information on way covers and or way cover wipers, visit HaasCNC.com, and thanks for watching.